Ghosts to the rescue. Buried a kilometer under a mountain in Japan, 13,000 electronic eyes sit vigil over a tank of ultra-pure water. This is the Super Kamiokande detector at the Kamioka Observatory in Japan. Each eye is 20 inches wide and sensitive enough to detect single photons. They wait, in total darkness, shielded from radiation by the mountain, submerged in 20 Olympic-sized swimming pools of water. The eyes wait patiently for a flash of light to appear in the water. If they're lucky, this happens maybe once every 100 minutes. But what could cause a flash of light out of total darkness? Ghost particles. The flashes are due to a tiny particle known as the neutrino. Neutrinos are so small and light, it takes half a million of them to equal the weight of one electron. Further, they have no electric charge and so can pass straight through normal matter, even whole mountains. A wall of lead one light year thick would only block half of them. Quote, neutrinos are really pretty strange particles when you get down to it. They're almost nothing at all, because they have almost no mass and no electric charge. They're just little wisps of almost nothing. End quote. John Conway in PBS interview, 2011. The infrequency of neutrino detection at the Kamioka Observatory is not because neutrinos are rare. Neutrinos are everywhere. Each second, 100 billion neutrinos pass through the tip of your thumb. On Earth, most neutrinos come from the core of the Sun. About 2% of the Sun's energy is radiated away as neutrinos. To neutrinos, the Earth is transparent. Day or night, they pass through us, unnoticed. This has earned neutrinos the nickname of ghost particles. This is why neutrinos are so hard to detect. Only once every few hours, is a neutrino stopped by the massive water tank in Kamioka. But on February 24, 1987, something strange happened. It had not happened before nor has it happened since. In the span of 10 seconds, the Kamioka Observatory registered 12 separate flashes. It was not a problem with the equipment. At the same time, and on the other side of the world, the IMB detector in Ohio also saw a flurry of flashes in their neutrino detector during those same 10 seconds. Something, somewhere, released an incredible burst of neutrinos. As it turned out, the source of this neutrino burst was something far away and long ago, the death of a star beyond our galaxy. These neutrino labs were the first to detect the explosion. Astronomers wouldn't notice the event until several hours later. Today, a network of neutrino labs now form our supernova early warning system. In 2002, Masatoshi Koshiba, who directed the neutrino experiments, and Raymond Davis Jr., who built the first neutrino detector, shared the Nobel Prize in Physics for the detection of these neutrinos. Given their ghostly nature, it would be easy to write off neutrinos as playing no important role in the universe, and having no relevance to life. But we owe our existence to the tiny neutrino. It is the neutrino that rescues oxygen and other vital elements from disappearing into the collapsing core of a dying star. During a core collapse, 100 times more energy is released in 10 seconds than our Sun will emit in her 10 billion year life. Around 99% of this energy is released as neutrinos. Only a ghost particle could escape from the core and reach the outer layers of the collapsing star. There they deposit a little of their energy, giving the outer layers enough of a push to blow the star apart and save elements like oxygen from otherwise certain doom. There would be no oxygen, no water, and likely, no life, if it weren't for the neutrino and the role it plays during the deaths of these giants. Quote, a very interesting question to me is the universe more complicated than it needs to be to have us here? In other words, is there anything in the universe which is just here to amuse physicists? It's happened again and again that there was something which seemed like it was just a frivolity like that, where later we've realized that in fact, no, if it weren't for that little thing we wouldn't be here. I'm not convinced actually that we have anything in this universe which is completely unnecessary to life. End quote. Max Tegmark in What We Still Don't Know, Why Are We Here? 2004.